We are actually in Indian Wells, just right next to Palm Springs, where there's a big tennis event that's taking place, BNP Paribas event. It's thought of as the fifth major. I want to get some context. It's a why marker is here, not just celebrating a great quarter and a dividend hike that's given the stock, got the stock at a 52-week high and doing well. But why are we here at this event?
Yeah, well, you said a little bit of it, Corey. I mean, this is a big tennis tournament. It's actually the tournament itself is been bought by Larry Ellison several years ago. As you can see around us, which I'm sure the viewers can, he's just upgraded the facility to a fantastic place. And then we, the company, are a sponsor along with BNP Paribas of this tournament. And then we use it as a tremendous customer event. So we've had 500-600 customers through here over the past week.
Well, I know you're very customer-focused, too. I want to talk about the quarter, because I thought this was a really interesting quarter from Oracle. In some ways, it was a lot of trends continuing, some accelerating, but some really remarkable. And the one that struck me the most was the enterprise infrastructure as a service business. Infrastructure is essentially the business that competes, the cloud business that competes with Amazon Web Services and competes with Microsoft Azure. And I wonder, the growth really accelerated. The guidance was even for greater acceleration of the growth.
Right.
What's driving that?
You know, Corey, I think it's a culmination of all the things we've been doing over the past several years. I don't think this should be looked at as an event. It should be looked at as a culmination of a lot of activity, our strategy. I think there were many good numbers in the quarter. I think the software as a service, platform as a service numbers, we grew 86%. I mean, it's a big number.
Yeah.
Our infrastructure number was big. I'll tell you, it's going to get yet bigger. It's a bigger market. It's a bigger opportunity. But the way I think you should look at it is actually the execution of our entire strategy, the application strategy, the platform strategy, and the infrastructure strategy. And we're excited about all of it.
So how do those other strategies hit that infrastructure as a service business?
Yeah, we started, if you will, several years ago, building out the application layer, or if you will, what's called SaaS.
Right.
We then really worked a lot on
platform. So basically the way to do different stuff, but do it on the cloud as opposed to the software.
Yeah, so applications like ERP and HR and sales and marketing, et cetera, and it was really important to build that out first. It's harder to go from bottom up than top down. So going from applications down is usually an easier strategy because applications are hard. We then moved our platform. We've got things like Linux, the Java, the Oracle database, and we really went after the platform business, and now we're really optimizing the infrastructure as a service business, for the rest of the strategy.
So as that grows here, you know, I never would have thought I was talking about Amazon as a competitor to Oracle. And it's much smaller, software business much smaller, database business infinitesimally smaller. But coming on and gaining market share, and I wonder what you make of that SQL Server also doing better than it has in the past in database in terms of market share. And I wonder what the effect is on your core database product.
Let me give you a view of the business a little differently than the way we've just been talking about. If you looked at our database business across our support business, our license business, and our database as a service cloud offering, our database business in the quarter grew in totality. And my guess is also gained share. So our database business is very strong, regardless of where actually you place the database. Now, from an infrastructure as a service perspective, there are going to be things we can do on our infrastructure with our database that nobody else in the world can do.
Google, Microsoft, Amazon.
Nobody. So whether it's clustering, security, performance, any of those things that you would like to do with a sophisticated database like ours, nobody will run the Oracle database better than Oracle.
And do you think that's why you're seeing that sort of flywheel effect where the growth is getting faster even as this business gets bigger?
I think it's actually going to go bigger. I think if we were using a baseball analogy, I wouldn't say this is the first inning. I would say we're still in the dugout. I mean, we're just about to come out. This is going to be a huge growth business for us.
So as we see this business growing here, you know, one of the characteristics of Oracle for a long time has been very, very strong margins, both on a gross basis, obviously, but on an operating basis. One of the things Amazon's been willing to do with their overall business is to go to very low margins. Now, we haven't necessarily seen it in web services, but I wonder if you're willing to get into price wars with these guys, if you're willing to try to take market share now because you are still in the dugout.
Well, A, we're going to be very aggressive in price. B, we've got much, inside that being aggressive in price, it's also about cost. We happen to bring to the cost equation all of the pieces. We have a hardware business, we actually have an operating system business, a database business. All of that IP is with us, so our cost base is actually materially lower than almost everybody else.
Why is that?
Because we own all the components. So that IP, we don't have to go out and buy the database from somebody. We don't have to buy the operating system from somebody or buy the hardware from somebody. We have a lower fundamental cost base. And we also have scale. So when you add those together, we think we can be extremely competitive. But it isn't, Corey, just about price. It's going to be about those other things that I described. It's going to be about availability. It's not helpful when you go down in the middle of the day. You have to be available. You have to be
secure.
Who
went down in the middle of the day recently?
I don't know. That's what I heard.
Amazon, I think.
Somebody. And so as well, but it doesn't matter who it is. You can't go down. You know, you have to be available. You have to be secure. You have to be able to drive performance. Some of these databases, Corey, run companies. I mean, they run not just companies, they run core processes. So they have to be secure and they have to be performed. Nobody will run the database in the world better than we will on all of those dimensions.
So that's going to give you the tool to keep margins healthy.
Yeah, and we have several advantages in the core technology that we think gives us a heck of an advantage.
You played college in tennis, or sorry, you played tennis in college.
I did.
You play a lot of tennis still.
Yes.
Larry Ellison plays a lot of tennis.
He does.
You probably play Larry. Do you keep score?
To be honest with you, we actually don't play.
Really?
In fact, to tell you, sometime tonight.
No, we don't.
But sometime tonight, I think he's actually going to hit with like one of the best tennis players in the world.
Fantastic stuff. Yeah. All right. Mark Hurd, thank you for having us down here. It's great
Corey,
stuff.
Thank you. It's great
and
to have
congratulations
you.
Congratulations on that great quarter.
Yeah, thank you.